come here in Europe and get into depression. For me, I prefer my freedom back in Africa with nothing. Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to speak the truth about life abroad as a foreigner, and especially as an African. And don't believe the hype. Life abroad is not a bed of roses, as many people want you to believe. When you see them going back to Africa, gushigang with Fendi, Gucci, and some of them are fake, and they with their acquired accent, fake accents. Don't believe the hype. Life abroad is so hard, and I've seen so many people dying of depression, and yes, because they can't risk to say, I am suffering, guys, help me. They don't want to go back home, because as you know, people back home in Africa, they think the minute you enter a plane, you are balling, you are rich. And it's not true. I will speak out of experience. I've been here for almost 10 years now. I came here in my early 20s. I mean, I'm in my early 30s now. And the first 3 years, guys, was not easy for me. I almost went into depression. Why? Because this is a new country, new culture, new language. Especially if you go to those countries where the main language is not English, give yourself around 3 years for you to be able to learn the language. I remember when I came here, and I was so sad. I felt homesick. I was like, is this the right decision? Did I make the right decision to come here? And I could not get a job immediately, because even if I had my papers, because I did teaching, kindergarten teaching in Africa, I also did beauty classes, beauty school. And when I came here, lo and behold, all my documents were not valid. Either I had to go back to school and do 3 years of whatever I chose to do. I remember even I had a driving license back at home, but when I came here, I had to do it all over again. And I'm telling you, the first 3 years were not easy. I almost gave up. I was like, no, hell no, I'm going to go back home. Plus, let me tell you, when I got married, I did not even take 1 year and I got pregnant. So you can imagine, I remember I used to study driving classes. I would study up to 3 in the morning, because it was in Italian. 1 year, less than 1 year, I've not even learned nothing, leave alone the simple grammar. So you can imagine me doing the quiz on the computer in a foreign language, pregnant. I remember where I took the test 3 times. And also, some people think that the minute you get married here, you automatically get a permanent permit or documents to stay here. It's not true. I remember when I got married, like here in Italy, you have to be married for 5 good years for you to be given permanent papers. Like, I was given 5 years, and in these 5 years, if the marriage does not work, you will be deported. And so many people, maybe you get married and things get sour, because you never know with life. You find the other spouse, maybe the white guy you're married to, he will start threatening you. Before the 5 years are over, he starts threatening you. Like, if you don't do this, I'm going to get you deported. If you don't do that, I'm going to get you deported. So you become, in some sort of way, a slave, because you are at the mercy of this guy. Some of the women that I've seen here enduring domestic violence, because you just want to stay there up until maybe the 5 years are over for you to be given permanent documents to stay here. Me, when I go back home, I don't lie to my brothers and sisters and my friends when they tell me, so you hook me up, so you help me to go abroad. I always tell them, you come abroad to do what? If you have a job back in Africa that is paying you maybe 30,000, 40,000, you don't need to come here. Like here, minimum salary is 80K, that is 800 euro, 1,000 euro. But I'm going to tell you, 1,000 euro here is nothing, especially if you have a family. Just let me tell you how much. Like, during winter, to pay for heater, just the heater so that you can heat the house so that you don't freeze to death. We pay 30,300 euro. So let's say you're earning like 800 euro. You pay 300 euro for heater, 200 euro for water, 100 euro for electricity. What will you remain with? Nothing. So when you tell people, the people back home, they call you and they will ask you for money and you say you don't have, some of them say, oh, that one is stingy, she lives abroad but she does not even help us, she lives abroad but she has not even built a home for her mama, she lives abroad but she does not pay school fees for her brothers and sisters. Because you don't know what really happens behind here. That's why when I go to Africa and I tell my brothers and sisters, it's not easy. Guys, it's not easy. You know, some of them will not tell you the truth. They prefer to come there with their quiet accent. Hello, my darling, my whole life abroad is a bed of roses. No, some of them even have to save. You have to save for almost 2 years for you to be able to go to take that 2 weeks vacation. Yeah, they are not going to tell you that, but I will tell you because I don't have nothing to hide. Especially those wazungus that you see in Mombasa, Watamu, some of them they have to save for 3 years for them to be able to come there and do a 10-day holiday. But when we see wazungu back in Africa, we think, oh, mzungu, mzungu. Some of them are poor. Yes, there are even wazungus in the streets who don't have nothing to eat. Of course. Some of you will not believe me, but it's true. I thank God that at least I'm not rich, but I thank God that I'm not suffering. At least we are not paying rent. At least all our cars are paid. And yeah, that's why even here when people come back to Africa, people are like, oh, you only have 2 children. When are you going to get the third baby? You cannot. 3 children here, you can't. Here you need to run. Some people here, they even have 2 to 3 or 4 jobs for them to make the ends meet. Especially if you live alone. Life here is hard. You will find even 18 people, 10 people living in one house because you cannot afford to pay your rent. Like here, rent, let me say, 1-bedroom apartment here where I live, it goes from around 60,000. Let's say you're earning 1,000 euro, 100,000, but the rent is 60,000. You have not paid gas, you have not paid electricity, you have not paid water. How are you going to survive? You don't. That's why many people, they end up doing crimes because you cannot sustain yourself. Back home, they're still calling you, hello, we need money for school fees. Hello, someone is sick. Hello. And all these factors make some people go crazy. And that's why most people come back home in caskets. Yeah, they come back in caskets because they could not deal with life here. They died with so much pain, but they prefer to stay here and suffer in pain and act like, oh, everything is happy and rosy over here, than saying, hey guys, back home I'm suffering and I prefer to go back home to be with my family. Loneliness is real abroad. Sometimes I get homesick and I'm like, I really want to go back home. Also, you cannot travel every year. Like me, if I need to come back to Africa with my children, I need to have like around 3,000 euros for me to be able. That is only air ticket. You don't have money for your upkeep back home, for whatever. So let's say 3,000 euro. That is 300,000. How can you go back every year? Me, I prefer to say the real and tell you how it is. Before you embark on a journey, either in a boat, thinking that abroad life is a bed of roses, be very careful. I have seen so many people dying in the sea because they think that in Europe life is, I don't know. I'm not talking about those people who run away from war and tribulation back in whatever country you're coming from. I'm talking about those people who sell everything back in Africa and they embark on an unknown journey thinking that out here everything is all rosy. I have seen even so many guys get into drugs, young men get into drugs, young women get into prostitution Because they prefer to stay here and suffer. They prefer to stay here and maintain the high life than calling back home and say, guys, send me a ticket. I need to come back home because life is not easy out here. So anyway, let me stop rambling and just summarize that life is not easy out here. It is so hard. And before I embark on that journey to go to another country, be careful. Weigh your options. Is it better to be free in Africa and get your daily bread without being so rich, or coming here in Europe and be a slave, come here in Europe and suffer, come here in Europe and be a prostitute, come here in Europe and start selling drugs, come here in Europe and get into depression? For me, I prefer my freedom back in Africa with nothing, in the comfort of my family, where with the little that we have, we share, than going to a foreign country and suffer. Yes, that is my life experience over here. If you like this kind of video, give it a thumbs up, share it, let people know that it's not easy out here. And I prefer to speak the truth because they say the truth is setting me free. I don't go back home and act like, oh, life is so easy over there. We collect money from the road, no. Anywho, thank you so much for watching and see you in the next video. Bye-bye. Ciao.